What's going on, everyone? Welcome, Rabbit here, and today we're going to be looking at some Jazz miners and a new king for ETC, as well as Ethash is about to emerge. So in the bathroom I do have the X41U, and out here is the X4Q. Now Q stands for quiet, because this thing, you can't even hear it. It hardly uses any power. It does a little over 1 gigahash, and it's an ETH hash, ETC hash monster. Now the downfall with these Jazz miners, with the 1U as well as this Q version, is they only got like 5.5 gigabytes of memory, so they can no longer mine things like FW or ETF. Now, things are changing, and the X16 is almost among us, and not even Bitmain stands a chance versus this miner. Now, this video is brought to you courtesy of Jingle Mining, who is a sponsor of the Rabid Mining channel and the main partner of Jazz Miner themselves. Now, I don't know if you guys remember, but I sure do. Remember when Ethereum was around, everything was profitable, and we've seen the numbers of the Jazz Miner X4, and we're like, wow, are these Jazz Miners legit? They look 100% scam. We didn't know what was going on. Then finally, we were able to see some real numbers on these products, and they pretty much blew our mind. Now, ever since Ethereum did move the proof of stake, obviously there's too much hardware out there. The GPUs are flooding all the networks, and things just aren't profitable. And that's where efficiency really comes in, and that's where these Jazz miners are the king of efficiency miners. Again, we're not here to buy the coin. I do feel ETC will see some really good gains moving into the next bull round around that 2025 range. So again, not financial advice, but we're looking into the mining aspect. And what happens in bull runs? Hash rate goes through the roof. So you're going to have to run at the highest hash to watt ratios and reduce that power bill. And that's what these Jazz miners do. So the Jazz miner X4Q right here is about 1.1 gigahash or so, because it does get a little bit more than what it's reporting on the website. And it only does it around 500 watts, maybe a little bit under. And then the 1U in the bathroom there, it's around 500 to 700 megahash at about 290 to 300 watts or so. So they're very efficient. But now let's go to the workstation. We're going to have a look at the X16 and kind of compare it to Bitmain's latest E9 Pro, and just give you an idea on how much of a beast the X16 really is. So we're over here at Jingle Mining's website, and right off the start, I want to point out the delivery date has been extended, or I guess delayed, to June 30th. Originally, this was May, but I have a feeling this has something to do with the crypto conference coming up around July, and it seems like even the Ledger Stacks and all sorts of other miners are being delayed, probably for a release closer to this conference, so that they can display their miners all as the latest, greatest, best thing. So again, I don't know if that's actually what's going on here, but it seems like a lot of things are being delayed for around the same dates. Now, moving on, let's just take a quick look at some specs here. And this thing does have 8 gigabytes of memory. The hash rate is estimated to be about 1.8 gigahash. Now, the other ones do perform slightly better, so we could see 1.9 to 2 gigahash coming out of this model. And the crazy thing is, it'll run on 120 volts because this only draws 630 watts. You can imagine almost 2 gigahash of hash rate on Ethash or ETC on 120 volts, only 630 watts. That's pretty crazy. That's insane amount of efficiency there. Also, a few changes have happened versus the other models, where this has a Wi-Fi antenna. So you can legitimately, don't even have to hardwire this in, depending on your internet and wireless connections, you can put that anywhere in your house and just run it off Wi-Fi on 120 volt. That's a pretty big deal, especially for home miners and apartments and so on, because one, it doesn't make any noise. It's based on the Cubase, and that thing is dead silent. And two, it does have that Wi-Fi connectivity, which is, you know, pretty amazing. Now, one thing I do want to point out here, previously people were getting high shipping costs by using the website, and I was referring people, hey, go talk to support alone, and they can get you cheaper shipping options, almost like 50% or something. But now it looks like they did fix everything. They tweaked out the website, so shipping should now be cheaper than what it previously was through website ordering. And I will have links to these, as well as code RABIDMINING will grant an additional 1% off. Now, this is a pre-order, and again, they're not expecting any delivery dates until June 30th. So keep that in mind, and maybe extend it, or maybe it'll happen faster. I doubt it, but you never know. Now, here is the Bitmain E9 Pro, and originally it dropped at only like $1,299. That was a pretty good deal, but now the recent one is now up to $3,499, so $3,500 for the E9 Pro. Now, we do see some more hash rate here at 3.6 gigahash, but it's drawing 2,200 watts. That's quite a bit. You could get two of those Jazz miners and only be using like 1200 watts, a little over 1250 or something, for the same amount of hash rate. So they are way more efficient than this E9 Pro. And there was rumors that Flexpool was allowing ZIL mining on the E9 Pro, but it turns out that is false and it doesn't work. As for the Jazz miner, it still does not sound like these things will mine ZIL, but Jazzminer is working on firmware to potentially let that happen. I haven't heard back from them yet, so far it's still a no-go, but the option may be there in the future, but we don't know. Regardless, what this thing is designed to do is mine ETC as well as ETH coins, and if any of those do pump and this thing becomes extremely profitable, which I really think it will with just ETC alone, but we'll have to see what happens with that ZIL. But this is a dedicated miner to those algorithms, and it is the best one for those algorithms. So if you are a believer in any of the coins within those algorithms, this is probably the only miner you're really going to want to have. Now, if we actually run over to mine the ASIC and sort by efficiency on ETC, and remember ETHASH algorithm, it is the exact same in terms of efficiencies and hash rates and everything. So I'm just going by this, but ETC, we can see the X16 is at the top of the list, where the E9 Pro is actually in 10th place, being beat by 9 other miners. It's weird to see Bitmain's latest machines not really being number one, but they do not have the ability, it seems, to touch anything Jazzminer does dish out. I did fire a little spreadsheet so we can kind of see everything side by side between those two miners. So here we have the E9 Pro, we have the X16Q, and the X16Q times 2, just so we can kind of equal out the hash rate to exactly the same as the E9 Pro. Now on FW, currently right now, current prices on what to mine, on FW free power is $10.15, FW profit after power is $4.34, ETC on free power is $10.19, and with 11 cents per kilowatt hour after power, that's about $4.39. And the E9 Pro costs $3,499, coming in at 2200 watts and 3.6 gigahash. Now, the X16Q, you can see the numbers and everything right here. I don't know if you want me to read them out to you, but our current price of ETC right now is $19.92. Now let's have a look at the X16X2. So you're getting two of these. So say you go out there and you buy two. Now that's actually going to cost $6,198, up from a $2,699 difference of buying just the E9 Pro itself. And you're getting about 10 more mega hash. But you can see here, we're still only using 1260 watts for an additional 10 mega hash instead of 2200 watts. Now at the current price, to actually make up that power at 11 cents per kilowatt hour, it's gonna take like 2.98 years to do so. So pretty much 3 years just to make up the power. Now I know you're thinking, well, that's way too long, it's not worth it, but it's actually pretty good. So you got to remember what happened. So one, in a bull run, the previous spike was about $133 USD, and right now we're only at $19. So if we hit at least the previous all-time high, and I feel ETC could see 200 plus in the next bull run, but again, I have no idea. I'm just guessing here. I just feel it's going to gain some potential. A lot of people think it's not going to do anything, so we'll just have to wait and see. Again, these miners come down to if you strongly believe in a project or the coins that it can mine. But if it does hit these levels, that'll bring this power alone down to probably only like 4 or 5 months, you know, very, very fast
to make up that difference here. And then, as we know, with every bull run, hash rate does increase by quite a bit. And if ETC or FW, ETF, whatever coin that you are mining sees a massive spike in hash rate as more people build rigs, turn their rigs back on, and so on, efficiency becomes more and more profitable. So any way you look at it, the X16 is a dominant force over the E9 Pro, which is weird because Bitmain usually runs the market until they go head to head with Jazzminer. It seems like they lose. So pretty crazy looking at this. Now, also, if you're in Europe or you have very high power prices, it's a no-brainer. The X16 ultimately destroys the E9 Pro, the more expensive your power price is as well. And vice versa, the cheaper your power, it doesn't really matter. You just fire out density and mine whatever the heck you want because power isn't an issue there. So regardless, I hope these numbers kind of bring some light and some nice bright expectations to the future of ETC mining, as well as anything on the ETHASH algorithm. Thank you for checking out this video, guys, and I am pretty bullish on ETC personally myself, but again, I cannot predict the future, but I definitely want to get my hands on one of these. If you have any questions at all, let me know down in the comment section or join the Discord. Link is down in the description. I will see you on the next one. Rabbit out.